discuss petitions connected to the chair of the Public Service Commission, you know, at the departmental conference last August. I've been talking about this for a couple of years, finally we've got somewhere. For example, Georgia Power is just crying that they can't meet environmental standards on their existing coal plants because there's a very, it's not cost effective to retrofit and it would drive up rates for ratepayers. And they're saying they gotta take care of the poor people. I'd better get to their greenwasher news at the environmental conference, just literally the solar summit last August. I always end up somehow cheating those guys, imagine that. But would it be cheaper to retrofit an existing coal plant to build a brand new plant that meets all the standards, probably a little more cost effective that way? Or they said what they're doing now is converting plants to natural gas, but they're gonna have to completely redo the infrastructure to accommodate that. They're gonna have to build new gas plants. And that cost is going to add a significant amount to what they inject into their portfolio. New nuclear reactors that I mentioned are not exactly a cost-effective solution. At the Clean Energy Conference, I don't know how many of you were there, the governor gave the opening remarks, and we have people from 20 countries here who are light years ahead of us in renewable power. The governor's statement was, Georgia's leading the way in clean energy with nuclear, natural gas, and clean coal. No mention of solar or wind or anything else, nothing truly renewable. Didn't even talk about landfill gas. So, got a long way to go, but that's why we're here. I'm really glad to see you.